Hello and welcome to this fun and easy workshop. In this workshop we are going to make these lovely dolls with movable arms and legs. It's really an easy workshop and we are going to knit this complete with our circular knitting machine with 22 needles. So, hey yo, let's go and let's start. Find yourself some yarn in the color of her skirt, shoes and skin and let's go. For these dolls, we have to knit a few pieces. First, we have to knit a tube. And the tube has 40 rows for your skirt, 35 rows for your skin, and 40 rows for your skirt. You can make patterns as long as you make them about 40 rows. And we have to join them later. So when you do patterns, make sure you make them the same. So this is tube one. Then we have to knit shoes two times and they are 25 rows. No scrap yarn or something, just knit in the color of your shoes 25 rows in a tube two times. And then you are going to knit two hands and that's in skin color and you knit 20 rows. And you have to knit the legs and arms and two times, of course. I like to give them socks, but that's for later when I demonstrate how to do this. And that's 8 stitches wide flat panel. So this is what we are going to knit. I'm not going to demonstrate how to knit the tubes, but I'm going to demonstrate how to knit the arm leg piece. So, hey yo, let's go. Our arm leg part is just one piece and it's basically a flat panel. Don't run away. I'm going to show you how you knit this. It's really, really easy and simple and it goes really fast. And you can choose whether you leave them open. I like to leave them open, but you can also close the tube. But I think this is okay, so I'm going to demonstrate to you how to knit the arms, legs with the socks. And later I will show you how we connect the arms and the feet. So, how do we make that flat panel? I like to start with my sock color yarn. When you don't want to make socks, you start with your skin color yarn. You leave your machine just in circular knitting position. It doesn't matter where you start casting on, and you cast on 8 stitches. You finish behind the 8th stitch. I will zoom in a little bit. And then you make sure that your yarn is under that bump between the 8th and the 9th stitch, and then you put it into your feeder. So on the inside it looks like, oops, this 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 behind the 8th stitch and under the bump or peg things on the left, and then into your feeder. And now we are going to knit flat panel. We only have to look at what's happening here when the needles come here. For the rest, nothing happens when the stitches are secured under the needle. So we have to look at a few points that are happening here. When we crank backwards, we have to be sure that this loop slides off this bump. So let's see, I'm cranking backwards and watch carefully what's happening here. It has to slide off and then you give a little tug and it will close neatly. It will give a nice edge. And then you continue cranking backwards. Be sure that every loop that's around the needle slides completely down around those two little pegs. Of course, because we just cast it on, not every needle has a loop, but the loop has to slide down when there is one. See, around those two little pegs. This is the last one. Be sure that's also around. And then, this is our last stitch. We knit further until our yarn is sliding under this bump. This is our first knitted stitch. This is not a stitch. It's not going to be a stitch, but we are going to crank further backwards until the yarn is sliding under that bump on the right from your first stitch. And when it slides down, you stop and you crank the other way around. There you have to look at that the yarn slides down and that the loops are around those pegs completely down. So, and when it slides off, you give a little tuck. I give a little tuck with my left and see what's happening on the right. It gives a nice and neat side corner, now end, edge. Now this is my last knitted stitch. I've knitted till my yarn slides under. This is not a stitch. It's not going to be a stitch. No panic. And then you crank backwards. Now, this is slow motion. This is my second turn now. I count my turns, not my rows, but my turns. And we have to do three turns with our sock color yarn. So I'm going to knit further. This is my first stitch. I have to knit till the yarn slides under. And back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Knit further till it slides under. And back. And this is my third turn. Dus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Till the yarn slides under. But I'm going to change color. So I cut my sock yarn color and I put it to the inside, and that's where the first stitch is. Make sure that the loop is down. Then you get your skin color yarn and you just put it into your feeder on the right from your first stitch. You start your new row with your new color. That simple it is. This is not knitted. We are not going to knit with this one. We're going to knit with this one. So we start with putting our yarn before this one. And then we are going to knit about 45 turns. So I start knitting. Make sure that the loops are down. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Loop down the bump and back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Down, back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2. Three. Four. Five. Six. And you continue till you reach the 45th turn. When you have a turn less or more, it's not a problem. This is not exact science. Everything is going to be fine. I'll meet you back here when we knitted about 45 turns. So, say about 100 rows with your socks. I'll see you back in a few minutes. When you finished your arm leg piece, you can simply cast off. When you're not sure about the length, they have to be a little bit the same. It doesn't matter if one is shorter or longer, but when you are not sure, you just cast off without or you just take your work off without casting off, and then you can adjust the length by frogging a few rows. But that's, I don't do. I always lost count, but I don't mind. Because nobody noticed. Especially not with this funny doll. So, I've knitted my second leg. And they seems to be really almost equal. So, let's continue. How to make the hand and feet. We've knitted 25 rows for feet. And we knitted 20 rows for hand. We are just simply going to close them as we would close a hat. A reversible hat, just by pulling our cast off yarn. Make sure that the rib side is on the inside. And secure that. Then we are going to start closing our casting on side, and there you have to roll the rib side to the inside, and then you will get a nice ball, yes, without stuffing. Then you are going to take your needle and close this side, or secure this side, and then we make it a flat circle and we stick our needle into the hole we just created to the hole on the opposite side. So just make sure that you're not going through the both layers. And then you just simply knot those two together. Then you can cut it. And you take both pieces of yarn and put them back into your needle. Flatten your circle. Make sure that those pieces are on the inside. And now we are going to make the hand by just simply go to the side and stick your needle under a vertical loop, skip one, and go under the next one, skip one, go under the next one, skip one. And so you are going to do that all the way around for hands and feet. So we can make little balls of these pieces we just knitted of these tubes. So you go all the way around and then put it aside and make all feet and hands the same way. So do that and then I will see you back in a few minutes. In this part we are going to join our hands and feet to our leg arm piece. That is really, really, really very simple. We are going to start with putting some stuffing into our little hand. And then you close your hand a little bit so it will stay inside. And then you take your leg arm piece at the side where you want to join your hands. This is my sock, so here has to come the foot. When we made the hand, we had the needle still on the yarn, or I have. Then you grab your little piece, and stick your needle with the yarn with the hand on it through the casting off stitches. When you skip one, that's not a problem, and you just pull everything through. Then you can put your cast off yarn piece from the hand, arm inside your little hand, extra stuffing, and then you simply knot the tails of the hand together, and so you connect your arm without any problem, and it's connected forever. And then you simply knot them and put them all together into your needle and stick your needle through your hand, and then you can cut off your yarn pieces. And then we go to the shoe side. We take one shoe, you put stuffing in the shoe, you pull it a little bit closer, then you take your piece with the sock and I find my cast on stitches or something around that, and I just pull put my needle through. So now it's connected to the shoe. You can put all those pieces yarn from the leg into the foot. And then you simply knot the two tails of the shoe together again. You take all those ends, put them into your yarn needle and stick them through your foot. Then you can cut off those ends. And now your hand and foot is secured to the leg arm piece. So make the next one, and then we are going to finishing of our doll. So see you back when you finish both arms and legs. And we're back. I made my both arms and legs, and now I'm going to make the head. I take a long piece of yarn, doubled. This is the loop. I'm going to put the two loose ends into my needle. And now I'm going to close this way up. Now that's really easy because there is this track and we only have to join those two sides. I stick my needle in, pull through until that loop appears. Then I stick my needle through that loop and I connect it. So now we are connected, and now I'm going to find my first two vertical bars on the opposite side, so on this side, and I stick my needle under, not the colored one but the skin colored one. Just take two, and then here you also take two, and then you can put your yarn through, and where you got out you get in, over and over. Where you came out you go in, where you came out you go in, where you came out you came in. And you continue that doing till you are on top of the tube. When you're on top, you just make sure that you connected it nice and neat, and then you simply secure your yarn by making a knot, and then you can put your yarn to the inside, cut it. Now you make a knot, and you do the exactly same thing on the other side. So you are going to find the track you want to follow, and you are going to connect your yarn again by pulling your needle through the loop. We stick that in later, and then we follow the track again. We are going to connect both sides. Explaining is more complex than just doing it. To the inside. And when you're on top, you secure your yarn another time. Don't cut it. Now we are going to make this more round. So what are we going to do? We are just going picking up stitches from right to left, or from left to right, whatever you like, to the corner. Don't pull your yarn through all the way, because we need that piece. Turn, and then do the same thing on the opposite side, so we get a circle, kind of, where you want to crochet. Shay, you understand that we have an oval now. And now we can just simply put our needle through this loop and pull the whole thing together and secure that also with a stitch, with a knot. And then you put your needle to the inside. And you cut your yarn again, but we are not finished with the head now. Now we have to make the head. So we are going to connect the same yarn to the neck, and we're picking up, or we're putting our needle under and over stitches in the round. Make sure you don't pull your yarn all the way through. You're allowed to cheat and skip and do whatever you like. There are no rules as long as you go all the way around. And when you're all the way around, you can put stuffing in the head. And when you want to use a rattle or something, you put the rattle in. Do I have one? Yes. And when you think you have enough, you just simply close the head by pulling the yarn into a knot. And then you take, oh, I made a knot into my working yarn, no props. Then you take your ends. And I guess you know what we are going to do. I just stick it through. How do I lose my thing here? I lost it before I closed the whole thing. Okay. No rattle. Okay, so that's the head for now. You can cut off your yarn. And now the fun part is coming, almost. The thing is, we are going to close the side, but we have to put in our arm before we are going to close them, so that the arm is free to go through that hole. So, I grab myself a piece of green yarn. Again, I take my two ends and put that into my needle so that the loop is on this side. Now I'm going to join those two sides the same way we joined our head. But we make sure that we leave this open, that the arm can, you have to put the arm outside, of course. The hand, sorry, not the feet, foot. It has to be free, so you can move it. That's the only thing you have to think about. And then you can just connect it like this, like we did it before. And then we are going to do the exact same thing. Go on the two vertical bars, or whatever way you like to close this. I don't mind, as long as you don't go all the way to the end, because we have to first finish these ends. But we can start with closing those two sides, sorry, my English. Sorry. You know that the color change, we do one stitch by one stitch. And when you're almost at the end, you stop and start the same thing on the other side. So you're going to do that on the other side also. So I take another piece of green yarn, double, put it into a yarn needle. Then I take my second arm leg piece and I'm putting in it in. The hand is on top, yes. And then I'm going to connect this to the opposite side, the same way we did on the other side. Make sure that it's still free to move, and then continue to the end, and we'll meet again when you're almost at the end. Don't go all the way to the end. So now we're almost finished with connecting both sides to each other. You're going to put all the tails from the tube inside the tube, so they're gone. What we're now going to do is we are going to close this on the most easiest way by just putting it to the inside this tube. Just pick up your needle and close it the way you want it. I just do it like this. You can close it whatever way you like it. You just close one tube. Make sure you're not sew through the legs. And at one point you meet the other side. You know that I like to knot things together, so you just simply knot those two together and you stick the one on your needle between both layers to the inside. Let it come out and cut off. And then you continue with your next piece. This is this seam, and we're going to do this exact same thing on the piece on this side. And now you can choose. Or you close in between while you're passing it, or you leave it open. But I like to close it. So make sure this runs free. And then you just So between through all the layers, it's the crotch. And then you continue ending the last piece here. And when you're finished, you just secure your yarn and stick it between both layers through the to the inside. And let it come out. And now you have your basic doll. You can give it hair, you can give it faces. I don't like faces. I will give it hair. I have a tutorial how you can easy give it hair. I don't do faces because I think that that's not necessary. Okay, Pimmetje is party crushing now. So I say, when you liked my tutorial, give me a thumb up. If you want to see more of my tutorials, look for the Circular Knitting Machine playlist on my channel. And when you subscribe down under here, you can put on the bell and you get a message when I put new workshops online. Have a nice day. Stay safe. With love from Holland. Bye-bye.